I hate to say this, but there seems to be a real bloodthirsty crowd here tonight.
So if you didn't already know, I absolutely love pro wrestling. I'm especially fond of the years from around 1987 to 1992. I loved Hulk Hogan, the Macho Man, the Ultimate Warrior, the Big Boss Man, the Legion of Doom, and the list goes on. And of course, I also love movies like Ready to Rumble, as well as No Holds Barred, starring Hulk Hogan and Tony Lister, aka Debo, from Friday. With that said, a while back ago, I discovered a wrestling movie that I've never heard of. And of course, I desperately tried to find a copy to watch with no success. In 1987, Hammerhead Jones was released a video in a limited market, and I don't believe this ever got a US release. It wasn't until recently that I got my hands on the movie, so here we are. Let's discuss. Hammerhead Jones was written by and stars Ted Vernon. You may have seen Ted before as a lead role in the 1988 horror film Scarecrows, and he also has an executive producer credit for John Carpenter's Village of the Damned. Hammerhead Jones can be quite a bit over the top at times, but really, it's a pretty fun watch. It's about Hammerhead Jones, who is the championship wrestler at the American Council of Professional Wrestling. He's a good-hearted guy who spends part of his time visiting Catholic orphan kids, but don't let that fool you, he is the king of trash talk.
He's a good wrestler, but not good enough. If he behaves himself, loses a couple of hundred pounds, and gets back his number one contender ranking.
Listen to me, look at me, onion head!
Times are tough at the ACPW because the new owner, who goes by the name of Numbers, well, he's money hungry and he decides to force his wrestling crew to participate in death matches. Which at first I was really excited to see, expecting, you know, barbed wire fences and baseball bats, but really it's just a regular match with no rules or ref. Also, this movie came out in a time when professional wrestling was deemed more... real?
How do you expect me to write about wrestling? In the same language that I use to describe pro football or professional boxing? Man, wrestling's a joke. It's a bad joke. Well, I know it is. And you know it. I just wish one of you guys would admit it. Listen, you little cockroach.
So the first death match, well, it turns out pretty bad. The friend of Hammerhead who loses the match almost suffers from complete paralysis, which then causes Jones to try and stop his fellow wrestlers from doing more of those matches. Numbers then sends out a henchman to teach Jones and his trainer a lesson.
You getting the message? Is that a yes?
Let go of the bar.
I got a message from Numbers.
Boy, this movie don't mess around. After this happens, Jones goes on the hunt to find out who attacked his trainer. Okay, so you know how a huge movie trope is the scene in which the protagonist will march into the corporate office of an important person without permission from the secretary? We've all seen it a million times, but not quite like this.
What are you doing? Put me down!
Tell him I'm here!
Hey, what the hell? Are you crazy? Get out of here, huh?
Tell him!
Sir Jones is here!
Thank you. You better leave.
Sit down!
Once Jones gets the info from the boss of who did the damage, he finds him at a club he's working at and this really weird scene happens. Jones corners him outside this back alley with a random cop watching in approval.
I think you have the right to know why I'm gonna punish you. Not because you hurt a friend of mine, because you enjoyed it. Was it nice? That's why I'm gonna knock you into the next area code.
And no, to my knowledge, that cop never met up with Jones beforehand. It's like he just happened to be out there and was okay with all that happening. Earlier, I joked around that Hammerhead Jones is bad at trash talk, but really, he isn't the only one.
He is afraid. The man is yellow. Come on, cue ball. Why don't you crawl out from under that rock and get up in the ring with me? Where is he? Where is the great Onion Head Jones? Where is he?
Well, it's a fair question, ladies and gentlemen.
Jones ends up agreeing to do a death match on the terms of, if he wins, the boss has to quit the company. However, Mr. Numbers, well, he has something else up his sleeve.
You ain't fighting, Malloy.
You're going against a guy you never heard of. The
guy's name's Zarek, Prince of Darkness.
I can't help but notice how the name Zarek is similar to Zeus, like in No Holds Barred.
What was the name?
This movie also shares a lot of the same themes, however this one came out 2 years prior. Then, in preparation of Hammerhead's upcoming match, we are treated to a classic 80s montage. The one thing that attracted me most to this movie was when I found out who played Zarek. None other than Fred Ottman, who wrestling fans know as his time in the WWE as Tugboat and as a tag team with Earthquake as Typhoon. But most of all, he is infamous for his introduction to the WCW as the Shockmaster.
The Shockmaster!
Right.
The Shockmaster!
I told you. Oh God.
So you're the man that rules the world. They call me the Shockmaster.
Ah yes, there is nothing more menacing than a silvery, glitter-coated Stormtrooper helmet. But hey, I won't lie, in this movie, Zarek, well, he looks pretty dangerous.
Yes, I God!
Oh! Shit!
And you gotta love this sign, Zarek is a moron. So they face off and have their match, and it gets brutal pretty quick.
Hold on, Zarek! Oh, Zarek picks him up again! Throw him to the ground! Hammerhead just bounces off Zarek! Zarek has him by the neck now! Jerks him off the mat, and Hammerhead wraps his legs around Zarek! No good! Zarek, boom! We can hear those here! Boom, boom, boom! Hammerhead has hurt Zarek with a devastating series of body punches! Hammerhead's winding up, here it goes! Oh, Zarek!
Oh my God!
Hands down, the best part of this movie, it's when Zarek sees Hammerhead's friend who was injured in the first death match, and he decides to do something so totally non-PC.
But look at Zarek, there can be no doubt about it, he is lumbering right toward the wheelchair-bound figure of Mark Coleman. What's he always kicked the chair over? Coleman's on the floor, an absolutely vicious act.
That is simply amazing. That causes Hammerhead to go on a rampage and make a comeback.
No!
Go after Zarek! He slams Zarek head first into the steel ring post!
And here come Luke's devastating body punches again! Working on Zarek's ribs, which are all over!
No! Right into Zarek's midsection! Smashing those ribs! The giant is his!
And then Hammerhead pulls out the win, and again, another movie with kind of an abrupt ending. I was hoping to see more aspects of the story tied up, especially since the movie has a whopping runtime of 80 minutes. But as for the movie as a whole, it's obviously not an amazing film, but it's a pretty enjoyable watch. Some of the dialogue is a little ridiculous too, but there's something about these low-budget 80s movies that I just cannot take my eyes off of. Thanks again for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to see more obscure and hidden gems like this one.
Hammerhead! I'm gonna squash you like a